Find your seats. In the keynotes this morning, there was kind of this talk of technology and the human side, and was then excited to see the topic here being the customer first strategy through API-led connectivity. And I think the more that we can have sort of these technology conferences where we acknowledge, and there was some of that in Nomen's as well, acknowledge that sort of human side is great. And so I'm delighted to introduce Jonathan from AXA to talk about customer first strategy. All right.
Hello everybody. I will explain you our customer first strategy to API-led connectivity. What we will see today, just an introduction about AXA Group and AXA Luxembourg, the business and IT challenges, what we've done with the APIs, our success with two important steps. The first one, organizational change. The second one, API-led connectivity. And finally, value result and next, what will be next. About us, we are in the heart of Europe, in the center. It's a picture of AXA Luxembourg, great bar, great beer, but it's for another topics. We have the strong value about AXA for the group, but it's also for each entity. The first one is customer first. We need to think when we start a project about what the customer wants to leave. The integrity, the courage, and one AXA, because we are around the world, and being together and being different make us better. About AXA Luxembourg, we are a small company apart from the groups. The group is present in 61 countries and 105 million of customers. In AXA Luxembourg, we have two entities. The first one is AXA Luxembourg, and the second one, AXA Wealth Europe. This is a young entity that was created for wealth management. We are around 280 employees, and we manage 150,000 of customers. We have a small video to present you what we want to make live to our customer.
I know I can be where I wanna be if I work hard at it. If I work. I'll be where I wanna be.
This is the experience that we want our customer leave, to be present from the beginning until they have problems and to the end. For this, we have business and IT challenges to manage it, to have this such a good story. The first one, we need to improve customer experience. We need to be there when they need it. We need also to optimize internal processes for a fast processing and the customer be happy. And for sure, we have IT challenges. In AXA Luxembourg, we have more than 100 applications connected to point-to-point or to database directly. We have all COBOL programs, and it's hard to connect new applications because you have point-to-point, it's an old stack, and you cannot integrate easily. We have huge effort for support and maintenance, and we have a lack of visibility and security standard. And all of this make you need to make more effort to support to correct problems. And this you have problem with the time for innovation. And we have needs, it's not to expose API to partner. The mode is changing, and the people want to have more information on smartphone and so on. And you need to also integrate new package solution. For this, I will show you two main projects that we accomplished with the API to help and to change our customer experiences. And the first one was a fast processing of an expertise mission for the car. When you have an accident, we've connected our internal backends to create mission into an external portal for claims management. The employee of AXA Luxembourg don't need to fill again the data, all is sent to API. For an example, since more than 1 year that it's in production, we manage more than 10,000 missions opened fully by API. But we don't stop there. We say we can improve also. And we now react on event that is pushed by the expertise platform. We automatically make taking care garage payment. We get the document and put it in document management. For example, all of these tasks that are done by API don't need a human intervention. It's 2 ATP by month that they win. And now the employee can make other stuff to help the customer. The second one is the biggest project that we call Customer First that we started in 2018. We start with review our business processes, but also review our IT landscape. We don't have a customer database, a centralized customer database. Each application has information about customer, and you have synchronization during the night. And the project was to build a master customer database and a 360 view for each customer in AXA Luxembourg. And we achieved it, and now we have customer information that are updated in real time in each backend system. For our customer services, employee, and it will be launched to our broker next year, we implemented all information into Salesforce. The customer services have all customer information, contract information, claims information. When they receive the call of the customer, everything is centralized. They don't need to open different backends. But we say we can make more also. And we decide to create journey by APIs. It means when you make a change of address, the API detects it and creates a customer journey. It's all the steps that you need to be done for the customer. For example, when you change address, maybe you need to review your home contract. Maybe you need to send a new green card. And all of this is listed to our employees that they don't to forget. For the moment, we have manual step, but next year, we want to increase it and to do manually, automatically check by the APIs. If you make a green card in the system, it will check automatically the status to be done. To arrive to this journey to success, the first step was we need to change our organization. The whole IT organization was split into project teams. Each team are responsible of one project, and you don't think about make a reuse asset. We was having one production team for every incident, and they need to know everything. It's what I say. Each resource only work on one project, and it's directly involved. We don't think a reusable asset and the support. The new organization is now divided by competence. We create a core IT for home application, integration for APIs, and data for data and data warehouse and so on. At the same time, as we create the Center for Enablement. We have one enterprise architect that's leading, and each team leader is a member of architecture teams. And we create for the Center of Enablement, we design a standard process for API design. We do this also for home application and data application, but here I show you the one for API. We have validation by security and business. We always start from a business need. We validate the design of the solution, and then we validate the design of the APIs. For sure, for this, we can ensure reusability and long-term vision. The advantage of this new structure is each team is involved in all projects. We review the asset to make sure reusability is the main drivers. Each team supports production and making troubleshooting more efficient. And the team are evaluated not only on delivered project, but also in long-term vision. The project customer first was delivered 2 weeks ago. And if I'm here, it's because everything works fine. But we saw also that the business needs to change. The business is not yet ready to thinking about reusability. Project manager continue to have only one vision of the project, one vision of the budget, the timeline of the project. And we decide also this year in June to change our business organization. We have implemented a project office where we centralize all projects, and all project managers are all together around the tables. And we can create a reusable asset, and they know what is already available in API because we have a service registry where all business function is present. The second one is the API-led connectivity. If I bring back to the first project, the claim expertise, we start from system API. We create system API regarding the backend database because we don't have standard services. We add expertise platform, document management, and document creation. This is our basis. After that, we create the process API in the customer, third party, and auto home because it's the same line of business. On this, we decide to create a canonical model to be sure that when you speak APIs, the business can understand it, and they can, for example, for auto, when we say a contract for AXA, what is a contract of auto? And finally, we create the experience API to connect our insurance management backend and the expertise platform. It's for that we can react on events that arrive in expertise platform. The next one is the customer's first approach. Here in red, you have all API that we reuse from the first project. And the main point is also from customer API. If you check it, we was taking the information from one backend. Now we take it from master database, and we don't change the customer API process. We create the live API, S API, and we connect also four new frontend at the same time. We are able to create a 360 view with all DES API. This project was delivered in less than 11 months. The value and the result that we can see about this now 2 years of using integration platforms, we see that we have 10% of time for innovations, 25% of less effort, and 30% of fast integration. The time for innovation, they are pre-built connector and reusable API, with the developer focus on business value than creating point-to-point. For the last effort, we have a visible and controllable process. We have everything is monitoring. From the delivery we do 2 weeks ago, we saw some little bugs on one API, but it was not seen from the business. And we was able to fix it in less than 1 day. And 30% of fast integration, it's thanks to the API-led connectivity model and the reusable components. If you remember, we reused 6 API from the first project on the second one. And for the next steps, we want to integrate the new EALS platforms. But we need also an OCR, because we want to EALS claims to process automatically and don't use human. We can read it from the OCR and create and automatically close the EALS claims and reimburse the customer. And this is an improvement for the customer. We want also to integrate e-signature. For example, if the customer is not able to go to the broker, they can send it by email and they can do it at home. It will be automatically signed and the contract will be generated and send it to the customer. We already start to analyze and we know that 80% of the API we produce for customer first will be reused for the EALS platform. The time that we schedule to deliver platform is in 3 months to integrate the new platform. And the lesson learned, technology matters for sure, but the right tool can make the difference. Added value consulting matters can help you to start in a good way and create standard process and avoid to make mistakes. Thank you.
That's great. I'm curious about the last thing you showed there with the reusing 80%. Was that because of decisions you made before?
Because it was an analysis that we done, and we create standard API for the process management for ILS API, and we can expose the contract, and we know from the ILS platform, they can read the contract from the standard one we create for 360 view for the customer. And we don't need to change anything, we just reuse it. We will just add an experience API, and they can connect to other APIs. And it's a great time saving.
And so it sounds like part of that is that you have that sort of customer piece to yes. those APIs so that they remain the same in those two use
yes.
cases. Yeah.
The customer API remains the same for every backend now because we standardize with the Canonical model. And we don't need to create, we create a standard Canonical model with the business on how we want to see a customer, which is the main information, the email, what want to see, 1, 2, 3. And with this standardization, we are able to share with partner also more faster.
Yeah. That part was fascinating to me. Are there other questions?
Thanks. Oh, I do check around to see if anyone else has got their hand up first. My question this time is still the same as the last open banking one. I still feel like we're missing something with open banking as far as like the customer-centric view, but we're not really talking about wealth generation for the end customer because we're not measuring that anywhere. Like whenever you look at open banking, it's things like transaction volume, new business models for banks, you know, all of that sort of stuff. And I know it's really challenging because there's a whole range of other factors that are involved, but you've got a 360 customer view. Is there any work being done on seeing whether APIs mean that customers are being able to generate more wealth because they're able to have better insight into their finances, you know, like at a household or at a business level? Because that's not really on the, no one talks about that in open banking yet.
The fact is, we do this to improve customer experiences. And when you have the customer that call you, and if you can bring the answer very faster with the 360 view, it's a great answer for the customer because they don't need to wait to, and you don't need to search in different backends. And this is great because we start the customer service start two weeks ago, and we can see already some improvement and happiness from the customer.
All right, over there.
My company is starting to move towards an API strategy, but we what you said about project managers versus engineering managers resonates because we have project managers who want to deploy as fast as possible, which means don't add that 10% to make a reusable API. From the project manager's perspective, the way to add value for the customer, integrating some deeper financial insight, is to deploy the product as fast as possible. In AXA, did you face this tension between engineering and project?
At the beginning, yes, but it was a choice of enterprise to start with the integration platforms. And our CIO was also involved in it, and they give us a lot of support. And we decide and we say to the business, okay, let's give us some time. We will create something that we can reuse it. By this, now they view the benefit, but at the beginning, it's difficult to explain that you will consume a lot of money to create standard thing and delay some project. The customer first project was at the beginning we want to deliver in September, but we asked 2 months of two extra months because we want very sure to have a reusable asset, and the business understand it. But you need to have support from your direction also. It was a choice of company.
And regarding your slide with the different layers of APIs. How do you manage the monitoring of the application and the governance between several layers and the specification, the swaggers of each layer, and also connected to your organization with the new team organization?
Yes, we decided to use the API LED connectivity because it was a standard model for the platform we built it. And we have a standard service registry like a Swagger with all API that's separate in system, process, and UX experiences. We fitted a governance and we created a C4E. And this C4E, we have also the opportunity to create valuable assets. And our director is behind us to be sure that we create something that we can reuse for the future. It's also you need to have, if you want to achieve something great, you need to have the support from direction, and you need to understand, you need to make understand to the project leader that if you do this, it will be a better solution for the future, and we can speed up integration for the future also.
And the last question there at the top.
Thank you for the presentation. I had a question about when you said how important it is to involve the business in the Swagger definition validation.
Yes.
I'm wondering, how do you do that? Because when I talk to my business, they know nothing about API usually. So how do you make them validate what you have designed?
In fact, we create a model in UML to speak with them, but we don't speak about API and technical. We show to them a model. For example, for a contract, you have the base of the contract. It's always with a policy, a start date, an end date. For auto, you have the plate, the vehicle number, and so on. And we try to bring information that they can understand without speaking about APIs. We will transform the business need and the business model that we make together into the APIs. But we don't speak to them about API. We speak with a model that they can understand. And this is a process we start 2 years ago to involve the business when we make API design, API solution, to be sure that we create reusable assets.
All right. Another round of applause for Jonathan. Thank you.
Thank you.
And you have about 3 minutes to move between rooms.